I grew up here in Northeast Minneapolis. First, right across the river there on Nicollet Island, in what was Little Ukraine for a while. And then about seven blocks from here, on Adams and Broadway, where as a child I used to clean my dad's Buick after all our neighbors pelted the car with rotten fruit because we were Ukrainian, because we were DPs. I was born here, but my first words were Ukrainian. I still speak Ukrainian when I go deposit my money over here across the hallway. And I have to ask myself, what motivates me to feel the things I feel about a country I've never been to or may never be? And a lot of that is from my parents, who left their country after World War II and settled here. People who at one time knew a Ukraine before communists came and took Ukraine away. People who told me the stories of what it was like to be forbidden to speak your language, to be told that you should turn in your neighbors if they were speaking a different language other than Russian. Who took their religion away from them. And I've often wondered, Ukraina, they say in the old books, means borderland. It's the word for borderland. So if you think about Ukraina, Ukraina, according to history, is a place that doesn't really exist. It's a place that other countries refer to as borderland so that they can build their empires and say, this is the borderland between our country and their country. But I tend to think that the Ukraina that my father spoke of, it's almost a dream, a wish. It's a place where all of us like to hold on to a place and say, if this was the way the world should be, this is what Ukraina would be. But I'm not sure that Ukraina was ever that, or if it ever will be. But we keep it inside of ourselves because we're human and we want the best for other human beings. What I do know, my father has been dead now for 21 years, and he's still suffering. Wherever he is, he's still suffering. And in that light, I'm going to play a piece called Suffering, Perezhitya. Learned from a fellow Ukrainian that used to live in this neighborhood who passed away back in 1980, Mikhailo Chernyak, a wonderful mandolin player. So this is my Duma, Perezhitya. Thank you.
Thank you.